not in my ears, but yeah, I mean, I thought it was pretty cowardly, kind of pretty bush league, which, you know, there's plenty of tape out there to watch. I haven't seen it replay, but yes, I really haven't seen it, anything like that yet.
How do you feel?
I'm fine. I'm good. Good to go.
Did he hit your flesh with
it? Did he what?
Did he hit your flesh with the helmet?
Go watch the replay. I don't know. I mean, I remember getting hit by a lot of people, so go take a look. There's plenty of tape out there to watch. I'm not going to speak for what may have happened.
You know what Clark did at all?
Do what? Once again, I mean, I got sacked once again. I mean, he had some words and kept on keeping on, and one thing led to another. So, but you can watch the tape, go back and check it out, and make your own assumptions. So.
Did you feel like tensions were rising to that point in the game? You had a couple guys leave with concussions, other helmet to helmet.
I don't think so. I think it was relatively clean. Those things happen, and obviously, I got to play better and give our guys a chance to win. Defense was playing great, getting the stops, and had a chance to kind of tie the game there a couple times, and those things happen. Hopefully, we'll get Jew and James and Deontay back to as soon as possible.
Mason, what was Mike's message to you all after the game, regarding the play?
Just said, hey, own it, chew on it, and we got a long season ahead of us still, got plenty of games, get back in this thing, we'll get prepared for Cincinnati just like any other week. We'll continue to move on, watch the tape, and go through the critical analysis.
You think he should be suspended for the rest of the year?
I don't know what the rules are. I don't know, but I know it's Bush League. I know he's a total coward move on his part. I get. I mean, it's okay though. I'll take it. I'm not going to back down from any bully out there. So we'll see what happens. I don't know.
What do you think happens in a couple weeks?
We play the Browns, so I don't know.
Does it carry over? Pick up where
you? No, I mean, I don't. We're on the Cincinnati Bengals. We're focused on them. They're our next opponent, and we know we got to win games in the division to give ourselves a chance at moving on and keep stacking wins. So we'll take it week by week.
I know you don't want to use excuses, but is there a point where you have to when you lose your top two receivers and your running back?
I think with the guys we had in there, they stepped up, made plays. We keep them in tune with the game plan a lot. Tevin, stepped up, Johnny Holton. So we had shots, and we pushed the ball on the field and didn't connect sometimes. And obviously, turning the ball over four times does not help. And, that's on me. We had guys in the right spots. I just got to, put the ball there.
The 2-4 found you didn't convert either. How big
Yeah. Big time. Anytime you can't convert, it's another turnover. You're putting the ball back in their hands. So, those were tough, but we still had a chance to kind of come back and keep moving the ball, and we moved the ball well, I thought. Just ended up turning it over in crucial situations. So yes, they were critical, but you got to move past it. So
you said that words were exchanged and got heated, but it looked like he put his hands on your face mask. You grabbed his helmet. Where did it cross the line?
I mean, once again, where did it cross the line? Maybe when he took my helmet off and used it as a weapon. So. Once watched it, I'll go back and look it up. I don't really care. It's in the past. We're moving on. Got a big game against Cincinnati next week, but there's plenty of film out there to watch it.
You were helmetless.
Last one.
You were helmetless, and you kept coming at me.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, because I felt like I had a bone to pick with him after what he did, and I wasn't gonna. I appreciate the line always having my back and putting it to bed, but. I was angry. So, human.
All right. Thank you.
All right.